ऑलराइट। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी एक्सचेंज रेट स्टेबिलिटी व्हाई गवर्नमेंट विल हैव दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड वी टॉक्ड अबाउट एक्सचेंज रेट एप्रिसिएशन एंड डेप्रिसिएशन एंड हाउ इट हैज एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन डिफरेंट बिजनेसेस, ईदर इट इज एन एक्सपोर्टिंग बिजनेस और एन इम्पोर्टिंग बिजनेस। सो नाउ वील टॉक अबाउट एंड वी डिड टॉक अबाउट वाई इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ इज सेट एज एन ऑब्जेक्टिव बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड वी एक्चुअली आई अलाउड द स्टूडेंट टू एक्सप्लेन और गिव मी सीरीज ऑफ आर्गूमेंट वाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग दीज फोर पॉइंट। सो वी हैव कवर्ड अप टिल नाउ। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन एंड टूडे वील टॉक अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर्स that lead to economic growth. We need to discuss that. The first point is technological changes. So you understand this? Okay, let me just see who is there. All right. So technological changes. So this is one of the factors which can lead to economic growth. Now, technological changes means that now there is a new technology which can be used in the production process. So you know that if a new technology is introduced, it is normally efficient and more productive. So higher productivity will lead to higher production. And you know that when there is higher production of goods and services in a country, in a year, we call it economic growth, right? So this is one of the positive aspects. So it's not only about the productivity or higher production of goods and services. It's about lower cost as well, because you will require fewer amount of workers. Okay, I'll talk about it because that could be a negative impact of economic growth as well. But technological changes is one of the factors which can lead to economic growth. So it has a negative impact in the form of unemployment, as I just mentioned. Okay, let's move on. Discovery of new resources. Now, if a country is able to discover new resources such as oil or minerals or any other resource which can be helpful for the production of goods and services, so obviously now country's capacity to produce increases because now there are more resources. So it will lead to economic growth as well. Then we have increase in demand. So it is quite, whenever there is a rise in demand for goods and services, because for example, people are now getting higher incomes, so they are able to afford more goods and services. So when demand will increase, how it will lead to economic growth, that is my question. So I'll ask Abdullah Tayyab, how increase in demand will lead to economic growth? And do remember, here increase in demand does not mean demand of one particular good. Here increase in demand means demand of, yes Abdullah.
Ji sir, aap kya bol rahe the?
Okay, I was just explaining and then I asked a question from you as well. Let me explain it first and then you will answer the question. I am saying here an increase in demand leads to economic growth. So here increase in demand does not mean demand of one single product. It's about demand of majority of the goods and services which are produced in a country. So this is increase in demand. Now you will explain me how increase in demand will lead to economic growth. Yes, Abdullah.
जी सर, जब डिमांड इंक्रीज होगी तो लोग ज्यादा चीजें, ज्यादा प्रोडक्शन होगी, प्रोडक्शन की वजह से.
Why? Why when there will be an increase in demand, why producers will like to produce more? What is the reason behind it? There is a connection there.
सर, क्योंकि उनकी सर ताकि उनके पास जो है ज्यादा प्रॉफिट उनको जनरेट हो सके, ताकि लोग उनकी ज्यादा चीजें खरीद सकें, इस वजह से.
All right. So what if people, they are demanding but they do not have the money to pay? So then obviously they won't produce, right?
Yes, obviously, sir.
Okay, all right. Now, one thing you need to add in it, it's fine, but still there is another connection which can add in it.
Sir, jab purchasing power
Sorry, budget, come again.
When there's higher purchasing power, then there'll be increasing demand.
Okay, all right. No, yeah, that's fine. I'm saying we have started with increase in demand, and that is because of any reason, because of increase in income, change in taste or fashion, or maybe some other reason. But after increase in demand, why there will be an economic growth? Why businesses would like to produce more? So one connection which is there, that is when demand increases, it pushes the prices up. Do remember that, because I explained that in the previous class as well. When there will be an increase in demand of goods and services which are produced in a country, so obviously there will be a shortage of goods. And the shopkeepers or the manufacturers, they will observe that now there are lots of people who want to buy, but we don't have much goods available. So they will intentionally increase the prices, because they know that if still some people won't buy, still there are plenty of people who are willing to buy from us. So that is why increase in demand pushes the price level of the goods and services upwards, right? And when prices move upwards, this is actually a great incentive for producers, because higher prices means higher revenue will be obtained by the businesses, and higher revenue means higher profit will be enjoyed by the business, and that is one of the primary objectives of every business. So this is how you will link your answer. So that is why the resulting in economic number. If one producer, economic growth happens when majority of the producers or all the producers in the country, they are encouraged to produce more. Right? So do remember that. Now, next point is training and education. It is quite easy. So that is why I want to ask Ahad Islam to answer it. Yes, Ahad, can you answer it? How training and education can lead to economic growth? Give me the answer. Yes, Ahad Islam. Please, go ahead. Ahad Islam, are you there or not? You are not answering. It's not good. Huria, yes. Now you are here. Huria, why training and education can lead to economic growth?
Sir, there will be higher labor productivity, so they can achieve, have higher skilled and have better qualified workforce.
Okay, all right, very good, Huria. Great answer. So I'm very pleased that you are participating and your concepts are getting better. Great. And actually, that is the primary requirement of this paper. So training means, do remember, training means it is a process which enhances the skill level of the workers. Now workers become more qualified, as Huria said. So when workers become more skillful and qualified because of the training and education given to them, they become more productive. So now if the workers are able to produce more, it will lead to higher production of goods and services. And higher production of goods and services means more economic or higher economic growth. Very good. It's quite simple. Now we'll talk about, so we have discussed all the factors that can lead to economic growth. Now we'll talk about the problems of economic growth. Right? So there are some negative aspects as well. I told you, I didn't discuss that in economic growth, if technology is there, so unemployment can be one of the negative factors. Right? So we are going to discuss that one by one. Let's discuss them. First is demand pull inflation. Let me explain you that, because economic students might be familiar with that, but other students, they are not very familiar, or it's not that easy concept. Let me explain it. 166756. Who are you? 166756. Excuse me. mute your mic please. 1-6-7-5. Yeah, thank you. All right. So now, demand pull inflation, let me explain this concept. Okay, before we understand this concept, we need to understand inflation first. And although I did explain to you about inflation, but now we'll talk about precisely. Okay, inflation is, it is a general and sustained rise in the prices of goods and services over a period of time. So the key words which are there in the definition are general and sustained. I told you earlier, inflation is not that when the price of one product rises. For example, if price of cars is rising or price of cell phones is rising, it's inflation. No, it's not. Because the word general is there. Now, do remember, when we use general, it applies to everybody. For example, sometimes we talk about it. For example, if I say that, okay, the fat person, they find it difficult to move. If I say that, so one person can say, okay, so are you targeting me? So I normally say, no, I'm talking in general. In general means it applies to everybody who is fat, right? Same is the case with inflation as well. When we say it is a general rise in prices, so it means it's not about one product, right? It is not restricted to one specific product. So we are talking about all the products in general which are produced in a country. So that is why we always use the word general. Then we have another word, sustained. So we fell down the next day. This is not inflation. Because another word which is used instead of sustained is persistent, continuous. So if there is a general rise in prices of goods and services, it must be sustained as well. And that means that prices must keep on rising over a period of time. That period could be a period of 6 months or a year. Generally, whenever inflation is calculated, we take the period of time as 1 year. It can be calculated for 6 months as well. So now, that is why the term, the two words which are there, it is a general and sustained rise in prices of goods and services over a period of time. So I hope that you understand the term general and sustained, which is there. So whenever you define this term inflation, you have to use these keywords. Anybody who is having any problem regarding this can ask me right now. Otherwise, I can move on. All right. So no question. Okay. So now if you see the arrow, so now I have written it is the rate of increase in price. I told you earlier, inflation is the rate of increase in price. That is why it is always calculated in percentage, because rate is always in percentage. So inflation is always in percentage. Do remember that. Now we'll talk about the relation between prices and value of money as well. The picture on your extreme right. So now you see, inflation is all about the rate of increase in price. So there is a general increase and sustained increase in price level. So prices move upwards. As a result, value of money goes down. That is one of the drawback of inflation. So now, anybody who can tell me, what does it mean when we use the word value of money? What does it mean? So I want Gufran to answer. Gufran, what is value of money? Gufran, please answer.
Yeah. I don't.
You don't know. Very strange. Okay. Navyan Arif, do you know what is value of money? Because if you see the picture, prices are moving upwards and value of money is going down. So what is value of money? Navyan Arif? or Munir, you want to say, you want to contribute? Mohammed bin Munir.
Sir, ये शायद इसका मतलब ये होता है कि आप पैसों से कितनी चीजें या सर्विसेज खरीद सकते हैं.
Very good. Great answer. Munir, thank you very much. Value of money means purchasing power of money. Let me explain you right below it. Do remember, when we say value of money, that means purchasing power of money. Or we can say simple, let me just purchasing power of money. Or you can say how many goods and services can be bought with money. Right? This is how you can explain that. Now, if price goes up, for example, I'll give you a very small, a simple example. For example, there are 10 items which can be bought, right? And the price of each item is 100. So for that, how much money is required? Obviously, you required, that will be 10 into 100, right? That will be the amount of money that will be required to buy 10 items of 100 rupees each, right? So in that case, this will be 1000, right? So 1000 rupees will be required to buy 10 items of the value of 100 rupees each. Now, for example, if inflation is there, and for those 10 items, now the price increases to 200 rupees, right? Now with the same amount of now with the same amount of 1000 rupees, how much can you buy? Now you can buy only half of the items. Now you can only buy 5 items. Do remember that. You can only buy 5 items. And how we calculated that? Because there are 10 items, for example, they are buying 5 items and the price of each item is 2000. Sorry, I have by mistake written 200, 2000, right? So it means 2000 into 5, that will be how much? 10,000. So 100 and how much it is? Either it is 1000 or 10, Ramin. But what do you say? Are you there?
Can you repeat the
Ramin,
question?
10 into 100 is how much?
1000.
Is it 1000? Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
all sir. Right. Okay, all right. So if now the price of the 10 items increases and now each item is available for 200 rupees. Okay. So now with the same amount of rupees, that is 1000, how much you can buy? You can buy only 5 items because each item costing rupees 200. So 200 into 5, that is 1000. So what happened actually? The purchasing power of money has gone down. You can see easily. It's easy. Purchasing power of money has gone down. Earlier, with the same amount of 1000 rupees, you were able to buy 10 items of 100 rupees. Now, because the prices has gone up to 200 rupees, now with the same amount of 1000 rupees, you can buy only 5 items. Because now each item is of 200 rupees. So what happened? So we can write that value of money has gone down. And this is because of inflation which happens. So now people cannot buy the same item they were buying earlier. So it will lead to lower living standard of the people. I hope you understand this. So that is why the picture now is quite obvious. When price goes up because of inflation, value of money goes down. So anybody who is not clear about it, about the concept or the example I gave, just let me know. Anybody, I am waiting for the question. Any question? Is it clear to all? Mukarram, are you clear on that?
Yes, sir.
All right. Sabar Ashir, any issue? Saba?
No, sir.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much. So let's move on. So we were talking about, I have explained you the concept of inflation because I am about to talk about types of inflation. Reason, because let me show you the slide. Now, the first problem of economic growth is demand pull inflation. And the second point is about cost push inflation. So let's talk about these concepts now. So if you see demand pull inflation, so what happens because of increase in aggregate demand? I have used the word AD. It's very common, commonly used in economics. Aggregate demand. Now, it means the total demand of the country. Do remember, we are talking about the macro economy. So we can't say demand of one single individual. It's about the total demand of the country, right? So when it goes up, so obviously it creates a shortage in the market, and producers, they in the short run, they are not able to satisfy all the people because there is a growing demand. In the longer run, obviously they will increase their capacity and they will try to meet the demand which is growing. But in the shorter run, obviously, if in the longer run they are not able to meet it, there will be a shortage. And prices will start increasing. And here, prices means price of all goods and services which are produced, bought and sold, right? So this is what we call demand pull inflation. You can see in the picture, there are lots of people who want to buy one single house there. So obviously, all cannot buy. So obviously, the price of houses will go up. And any person who will still be able to buy will buy that house. The rest will not buy it because they do not have the purchasing power. So this is demand will pull the prices upwards. This is what that is why we call it demand pull inflation. And why demand is increasing? That could be for any reason. Income is increasing, for example. All right. Similarly, we have cost push inflation. Now, as you can see the picture, it can be because of increase in cost. So, for example, there is a factory there. You can see the picture as well. And now the factory is getting the raw material at a higher rate, at a higher cost. So, obviously, when they will get raw material at a higher cost, they have to increase the price of their finished goods, which they store in their warehouse, right? So, obviously, the final price of the product will go up because higher cost of material will have an impact on the final price of finished goods as well, which people buy. So here, the cost of raw material is pushing the prices upwards, right? But again, it's not about cost of raw material of one single product. It's about the raw material which is used by all businesses, okay? And they are using it, and that's why the price of their finished goods is increasing or going upwards. So one, this is one way. So we call it cost push inflation. The effect will be the same as in the case of demand pull inflation, that it will reduce the value of money for the people. And people obviously will not be able to buy more goods. Okay, another case of cost push inflation is, for example, wages is also a cost. If, for example, people, the workers, they start demanding higher wages, fine. So if they start demanding higher wages, so it will increase the cost of wages for the business. So again, in order to cover that higher wage cost, the business will increase the prices of their final products. So again, it will increase prices of the goods and services, resulting in inflation, but call it cost push inflation. So whenever your cost pushes the prices upwards, we call it. So now if you see the above, so can you actually tell me what is happening that if you, let me just show it to you again, whether you can see, can you, where there is a big mouse eating the eating money? Can I hope you can.
Yes,
is it difficult or not? Okay, all right, fine. Now, so what is this picture all about? Because this is a self-explanatory picture, and it actually tells the disastrous effect of inflation on the people and the economy as well. Aisha Siddiqa, can you explain me what is happening in the picture? Aisha.
So value of money is decreasing.
All right. So it means that inflation is eating up money. It means now you even if you have the same amount of money, it will look smaller to you. Okay. Why? So that is why, because now the prices are going up. So despite the fact you have a lot of money, but in value, it will look smaller. So that is why inflation eats up your value of money, basically, right? Because money may not help you satisfy your need and want at all unless and until it has a value. If the value of money goes down, obviously the importance of money also goes down. Simple as that. So inflation, what it does, it reduces the value of money for the people. Now people have to either have to spend more or they have to buy less. There is no other alternative there. Okay, all right. So you understand this concept. Let's go back to the original slide. So now you understand this, that two of the major problems of economic growth are demand pull inflation and cost push inflation. But now you will link it with, I'll explain to you what is demand pull inflation and what is push inflation or labor shortages. Why I have written labor shortages, I'll ask you and then I'll explain that. So now you will just relate it with economic growth. How economic growth can lead to demand pull inflation? First, I want to ask this from somebody. Let me see in the list. I think Mahnoor is done. Okay, Ramesh, please.
सर जब इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ होती है तो आपकी जो कंट्री की एग्रीगेट डिमांड होती है वो बढ़ जाती है, ठीक है, फिर ऑब्वियसली
क्यों
सर, क्योंकि प्राइसेस बढ़ जाती है ना, तो एग्रीगेट डिमांड भी बढ़ जाती है, मतलब प्रोड्यूसर ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस करना चाहते हैं.
लिसन हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, यू आर राइट, बट हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ,
क्योंकि इनकम बढ़ जाती है, उनकी परचेजिंग पावर बढ़ जाती है.
Very good, Ramesh. Thank you. Mahnoor, do you want to add or if you are more clear about it? Mahnoor Yazdani.
No, sir, it's okay.
Let me explain that precisely. No, just hold on. Okay, demand pull inflation, it happens because of economic growth. Why? Because when economic growth is there, more people are employed, because businesses require more workers, right? So when more workers will be hired, obviously income level will increase. Now people are in, so they will buy more. So when they'll buy more, it will lead to higher aggregate demand. And that higher aggregate demand will lead to higher inflation. And that is why we call it demand pull inflation. So this is how you will link it with economic growth. Yes, Ramesh, you want to explain labor shortages as well, that is cost push inflation.
मैं डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन ये कह रहा था कि जब आपकी एग्रीगेट डिमांड बढ़ जाती है, फिर मतलब वो एग्रीगेट सप्लाई को आउटपे कर जाती है, मतलब सप्लायर जितना प्रोड्यूस नहीं कर पाते क्योंकि एग्रीगेट डिमांड ज्यादा होती है, तो फिर वो ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस करने के लिए प्राइसेस बढ़ा देते हैं, जिससे डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन होती है.
एब्सोल्युटली, दैट्स राइट, बिकॉज़ व्हेन डिमांड इंक्रीजेस, द प्रोड्यूसर्स, दे आर नॉट एबल टू कोप अप विद दैट हायर डिमांड, सो एज अ रिजल्ट देयर इज अ शॉर्टेज क्रिएटेड एंड देन prices start moving upwards, and only those people buy who are able to buy it, others don't buy then. Okay, labor shortages. Now cost push inflation, how economic growth leads to labor shortages, and how it leads to cost push inflation as well. So let me ask Shujat Ali. Shujat, you are always there in my class very early. That's very good. But you need to participate as well. Yes, Shujat, please. Shujat Ali, please contribute. Shujat, I am big. Okay. Tuba Nasir.
Ji, sir.
Explain me that. How economic growth leads to labor shortages and how labor shortages leads to cost push inflation.
Sir, skilled employees nahi milenge, I guess.
Why?
Skilled employees. Kyunki jo workers honge wo pehle se employed honge aur jo baki honge unko training dene ki zarurat padegi.
Very good. Hold on. Usse cost push inflation kyun hogi?
उससे बिजनेस की प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट बढ़ेगी ना, तो बिजनेस जो होगा वो अपनी प्राइसेस बढ़ाने की कोशिश करेगा फिर.
वेरी गुड तुबा, थैंक यू वेरी मच, ग्रेट आंसर, वेरी गुड, वेरी रेलेवेंट. व्हेन देयर इज इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट मोर पीपल विल बी एम्प्लॉयड, राइट? सो इट मींस लेस पीपल विल रिमेन देयर इन द इकोनॉमी व्हिच विल बी अनएम्प्लॉयड. सो नाउ यू विल फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू हैव मोर सूटेबल वर्कर्स फॉर योर जॉब. Now the workers who are available, they are not that much skillful, right? So now, and people who are skillful, they are already in the job. So now you have to snatch workers from other businesses, and for that you have to pay them higher wages, because there is a labor shortage and you are not able to find the suitable worker for your business or workers for your business. So this is what we call labor shortages. Labor is not available. So then you have to attract them with good offers, higher packages, salary packages, right? So this will increase the wage cost of the business. And when wage costs will increase, so obviously businesses, in order to cover that cost, as I explained earlier, business will increase their price level of their goods and services. So this will lead to cost push inflation. And how it will have an impact on businesses, I explained you that. But I want somebody to answer, because I'm telling you, our purpose is not to explain the effect of inflation on the economy. We can explain that, fine. But eventually, the effect should be on the business. If it is not on the business, it means we can't be able to get full marks at all. So now tell me, how demand pull inflation, labor shortages or cost push inflation will have a negative impact on business. For example, I'll give you an example. There are two businesses. One business which actually sells grocery items. It's a grocery store and they sell grocery items on daily basis. There is another business, right, which runs a restaurant business. For example, a fast food restaurant. There are two businesses. So how inflation is going to have an impact on two businesses? Either the impact will be the same or will it be different? So let me ask Talal Mughal. Yes, Talal.
Yes, sir.
I just explained you. I have given you,
yes,
an
sir,
example.
Question repeat. Question,
there are two businesses, right? One business is a grocery store. The other businesses is a fast food restaurant. And inflation is going upward. For example, due to cost push inflation, because there is labor shortage. So now how it is going to have an impact on both these businesses? Will the impact be the same or different? Explain. Yes, Talal?
Sir, mere hisab se ke different hoga, kyunki fast food restaurant mein cooks ek skilled labor aur nahi sir, same hi hoga.
Same hoga. Okay, all right. Okay. Salman Masood. Yes, Salman, please speak up, because you do not do it very often. Salman Masood, I'm asking you. I'm telling you, but this way, if you won't talk, I will highlight your names. I'm telling you. All right. So, Fatma Shakil, please answer my question.
Sir, Abdul Jabbar ko add kar le.
All right. Yes, Fatma, please.
सर मेजरली तो सेम होगा, लेकिन ये कि फास्ट फूड वाले बिजनेस को अपने रॉ मटेरियल्स भी आई गेस ग्रॉसरी वाले बिजनेस से लेने पड़ेंगे, तो शायद उस वजह से उनकी कॉस्ट ज़्यादा इंक्रीज हो, तो उनकी इन्फ्लेशन ज़्यादा हो.
All right, let me explain that. I thought you will come up with a different answer. Okay, it doesn't matter. Now listen, if there are two stores, you know that grocery items, they are essential for living. So even if their prices are rising, people still have to buy. They might cut down their expenditure on luxury items. For example, if you go to a restaurant business, if you visit a restaurant to have a dinner, for example, or to have a lunch, it's not a necessity, right? So you can cut down your expenditure on restaurants, right? So it means the major impact will be on restaurants, because people will start saving their money because now they are too expensive, and they will spend more on grocery items because now they are expensive.
Sir,
but because they cannot live without it. Yes?
Sir, आपने लेबर शॉर्टेजेस कहा है, तो लेबर शॉर्टेजेस तो उसके लिए फास्ट फूड रेस्टोरेंट और उसके लिए, तो दोनों के लिए लेबर शॉर्टेज तो सेम ही होगी ना. बस ये है कि फास्ट फूड रेस्टोरेंट में थोड़े से ज्यादा वो स्किल लेबर की शॉर्टेज ज्यादा होगी, थोड़ा सा ज्यादा बड़ा फर्क नहीं होगा, लेकिन थोड़ा सा फर्क होगा. ये तो आप डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन की तरफ से नहीं बता रहे सर.
No, Talal, you are absolutely right, but I am saying if labor shortage is there for a grocery business as well and a restaurant business as well, now do remember, if there is a grocery store and now the wage cost is increasing because you are finding it difficult to hire workers and for that you have to pay them higher wages, so what do? They can increase the price of their grocery item, and they know that the demand will be inelastic because people have to buy it because it's a necessity, right? All grocery store owners, they will do it and people will still buy it. But in case of a restaurant business, if they will increase the price because of labor shortages, because their wage cost is high, people may not like to buy. They'll say, okay, we will postpone our spending on restaurants and we won't visit restaurants unless and until prices start going down. So this is why restaurant businesses will have a major impact on their profits, and customers may not visit, and there will be a huge fall in the number of customers who would like to visit restaurants. But it may not have the same impact on a grocery store. Talal, got it? Talal?
Sir, ये थोड़ी सी confusion आ रही है कि सर आप labor shortages को एक fast food restaurant के profit के साथ कैसे compare कर रहे हैं?
Because labor shortages means that it will, आगे bracket में लिखा हुआ है, it will lead to cost push inflation. Labor shortages always lead to cost push inflation.
Sir, profit to business ka kam ho raha hoga, labor shortage kis, yani profit kam business wo fast food restaurant ko ho raha hai, to sir labor shortage fast food yani isse thoda sa mujhe masla ho raha hai ki labor shortage ki wajah se fast food restaurant ka profit margin kam ho raha hai, to is tarah why would they the employees prefer to go to a grocery store rather than going to a fast food restaurant?
Okay, reason, okay, let me explain you that. I explained that when there will be labor shortages both in grocery store and in restaurant business, so what do the owners do? They will try to give higher wages to those workers, right, in order to attract them to work there. Okay, both do it. For example, grocery store owner and restaurant owner, both do it. They hire workers on a higher or attractive wage. So by doing this, it will increase their cost of wages, right? Both for restaurant owner and for grocery store owner. Now, in order to cover that higher cost, they will simply increase the prices of their goods, which they sell to people or customers. So now what will happen when there will be increase in price? Now people will choose or prefer to buy grocery items because it is a necessity. They have to buy eggs, bread, toothpaste, and other items on daily basis. They cannot live without it, but they can live without going to a restaurant. So what do, because the prices of both the items have increased, either it is a grocery item or a fast food. So people will stop going to fast food restaurant because now it is expensive. and it is not a necessity. That is why there will be a huge fall in revenue and profit for a restaurant owner business.
Okay, sir.
All right. Okay, now let's move on. Other problems of economic growth could be, one is rise in imports. When economic growth is there, there will be rise in imports. And I want Zainab Hamid to answer. Zainab, why, if there is economic growth, there will be rise in imports? Zainab, Hamid, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Gee, why, because of economic growth, there will be rise in imports?
Sir, matlab bahar se zyada imports aayengi.
Why? Why, because of economic growth? That is my question.
Sir, I don't know.
Okay, all right. Okay, no problem. Yes, please.
सर जी, जब इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ होती है तो आपकी जो होती है एम्प्लॉयमेंट इंक्रीज हो जाती है. जब एम्प्लॉयमेंट इंक्रीज होएगी तो लोगों की इनकम इंक्रीज होएगी. जब इनकम इंक्रीज होएगी तो लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स इंक्रीज होंगे. तो सर उस इंक्रीज्ड इनकम की वजह से लोग बाहर से लग्जूरियस आइटम्स इम्पोर्ट करना शुरू कर देंगे टू सेटिस्फाई देयर इंक्रीज्ड लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड.
वेरी गुड अब्दुल्ला वैस, और आपने सीरीज ऑफ आर्गुमेंट भी बनाए हैं. ग्रेट, वेरी गुड, एक्सीलेंट आंसर. Whenever there is economic growth, people will get employment, as he just said. So it will increase the level of income of the people. And now, to increase their living standard, they may like to buy high quality items from other countries because now they can afford it. So it will lead to rise in imports. And do remember, when there will be rise in imports, so it means more money will go out of your country. And it is not good for your country, right? This is one aspect, because now you require more foreign currency, and obviously then there will be exchange rate destability. Exchange rate will start fluctuating. Okay, I explained you that the mechanism of exchange rate. So that is why there will be rise in imports, and it is not good for the economy. But there is another aspect which has not been discussed. That is, when there is economic growth, it means now businesses, and there will be higher demand as well, because when there is economic growth, people will be hired, employment is there, so people have higher income, they will start demanding more goods and services, right? So in order to meet their demand, businesses would like to have latest or modern technology. So they would like to spend on those machines which are up to date and which have higher productivity. So for that, they may like to buy imported machinery, right, from other countries. So again, it can lead to rise in imports as well. So it is true both for consumers as well and for producers as well, but you need to link it with economic growth. Then we have pollution. It's very easy, so I won't discuss in detail that whenever industries will grow, so obviously there will be more pollution taking place. More forests will be cut, because if wood is being used, for example, so it will pollute the air more often. And similarly, they have to throw their garbage somewhere around. There will be land pollution there as well, because they will throw their waste material outside their building. There will be water pollution as well. Dangerous chemicals can be mixed into water, or can mix into the nearby river as well. Then air pollution will be there, because smoke will be released all the time from the factory, because the more they work, the more smoke will be released there. For example, if factories are working 24 hours a day now, so obviously it will pollute the air more. So that will, now it will have an effect on the health of the people living by. I have explained you that many a times, and it may cause many diseases as well. Exploitation of resources. I want somebody to explain me what is exploitation of resources. Aniza Hamid, can you explain me what is exploitation of resources? Any idea? Because now you have the notes. I have given the notes of chapter 9 as well. Aniza, yes, please speak up. Aniza Hamid. Okay, Bisma Haroon, yes. So you are silent. Yes, Bisma. Bisma Haroon, please answer my question. What
sir,
is
iska matlab ke resources use karna, lekin economy pe negative impact aaye.
Yes, okay, very good, but how? It means you use your resources in a way that it has a negative impact on the economy. It's fine, but how? Can you give me an example?
Okay, fine.
All right. Now, exploitation means if you use your resources too quickly. So it means, for example, if there are resources which are non-renewable, such as oil. So if you keep on extracting oil and start selling it to the whole world, as Saudi Arabia is doing it, right now there are lots of reserves available. But because you are exploiting it, it's not the need of your people. You are meeting the needs of the other people who live in the other parts of the world, right? So it means you are using your resources too quickly. And who knows, the time may come that you may run out of those resources and it may not be available for coming generation. And the living standard will drop down for the people who will come in the coming generation. So this is what we call exploitation of resources, and it happens because of economic growth. Because if there are too many businesses now and they are, every business is trying to produce more because now there is more demand, so obviously now the resources will be used too quickly. Earlier there were, for example, 10 businesses in the region, now there are 100 businesses in the region using the same resources. So obviously the resources are more likely to come to an end sooner or later. All right. Now, let me explain you that economic growth is just one stage of this concept. That is what we call trade cycle. Do remember that. This would be the last slide of our lesson today. Trade cycle, what is it? Let me explain you that. It refers to the ups and downs in the level of economic activity, which extends over a period of several years. Now, let me explain you that. It refers to the ups and downs and in the level of economic activity. Now, economic activity means when something is produced, either goods or services. So sometimes more goods and services are produced and sometimes less goods and services are produced. We call it ups and downs in the level of economic activity. But it can extend over a period of several years. For example, if production is going down in the country, so it may keep on going down for maybe another 5 years or 10 years. Okay. Or if it is moving upwards, so it may move upwards for another 5 years. So that is why, so it can extend over a period of several years. Now, do remember that growth is one of the stage of trade cycle. Trade cycle includes many stages. One is, and you can see on X, on Y axis, I have written GDP growth or economic growth, you can see. So, boom is there. Boom means the highest point which an economy can achieve, right? In terms of production of goods and services, when you reach, for example, to the maximum level of goods and services which you can produce, or at a certain point of time the country can produce, so we call it boom, the highest level a country was able to achieve or is able to achieve in terms of production of goods and services. Okay, the curve is going downwards. So it means we call it recession. Now, recession again means in terms of goods and services. What happens? Now there is a slowdown of economic activity. So production of goods and services, the amount of production of the goods and services will reduce because now producers are not producing it. So there will be lower employment as well. Okay. Lower revenue for the businesses as well. And sooner or later, they reach to the minimum level, that is slump. Now, slump means that now the economic growth is negative. What does it mean? Now, it means now there is reduced amount of production every year. Earlier, if one country was able to produce 1,000 units, the next year they are able to produce 500 only. The next year, 200. So it is very dangerous for an economy, slump, right? And then if there is a recovery there, we can call it growth as well, economic growth. From slump to recovery, it is an economic growth. But why we are calling it recovery? Because you are recovering from slump. So such an economic growth which comes after slump, we call it recovery. And then again, there is a boom there, and then again, there is a recession there. So the cycle, that is why we call it a cycle, because these stages come time and again, but their period of time can vary. It depends, right? But do remember, these ups and downs come in the form of GDP. Either GDP goes upwards or start going up, or it goes downwards or start going downwards. So same with the cases when GDP goes up, obviously employment also increases, price level also increases, profits of the companies also increases, and government is able to collect more taxes as well. Similarly, when GDP goes down or there is a lower negative economic growth, now negative, do remember, negative economic growth means production is going down. But when I say there is lower economic growth, it means production is still increasing, but now it is increasing at a lower rate. So for example, if there is negative economic growth, so it means production is going down. So there will be lower employment, people are getting unemployed, there will, prices will also move downwards, and businesses may not have enough profit to survive there. Okay, all right. So one stage is boom, recession, slump, and growth. I just explained you that. Now, any question up till that? Anyone?
No, sir.
All right. Okay.
Sir,
so thank.
Sorry. Yes, please. सर जीरो से बूम बिल्कुल स्टार्ट में जीरो से बूम पे जाते वक्त इसको भी हम रिकवरी कहेंगे?
नो इट्स नॉट एक्चुअली दिस इज नॉट एक्सपीरियंस बाय कंट्रीज बिकॉज नाउ ऑल कंट्रीज दे डू एग्जिस्ट सो व्हेन देयर इज जीरो इट मींस व्हेन अ कंट्री हैज जस्ट कम इनटू एन एग्जिस्टेंस एंड दे हैव स्टार्टेड प्रोडक्शन राइट सो और दे हैव गॉट इंडिपेंडेंस दिस इज अ सेपरेट केस अदरवाइज इट डज नॉट हैपन एंड इट इज नॉट अ रिकवरी When a country starts from zero level of production, that is just economic growth. I hope you got it. All right. So thank you very much. That's all for today. I'll see you in the next class.